I caved. This has been a very, very, very requested video for, like, years now. And my last tutorial might be a little bit outdated. Just a little bit. So I figured, you know, might want to redo it. And I'm just going to warn you guys, this is not for the faint of heart. This is a very, very difficult tutorial because I'm self-taught. So no one really showed me how to do things the proper way. So I take no shortcuts and I do everything the long way. So just gonna warn you, this is probably gonna be very complicated, and I hope you have, you know, at least a little bit of experience in making this kind of stuff. So just warning you. All right, let's get to the video. All right, so first of all, you gotta import the audio. I just screen record it, and then you export it into like the audio format. And after this, we get into the drawing. So now I do the drawing. So this is a little speed paint. This is done in Procreate. So this is Helios. And this is going to be an original meme as I'm making this. And I didn't know what the position was going for. I was kind of thinking like gay old man in a hot tub. But somehow it turned into the creation of Adam Renaissance painting by, I want to say, Michelangelo. And of course, top surgery scars because Slay. And I added wings, and I don't know why. And I don't even know if they'll get into the final cut, but yeah. So I started the line art. And now we go into coloring and doing the lip sync. So actually, for all of this, I'm stupid and I totally forgot to record the whole thing. Like, I know Flipaclip has a time-lapse feature, but it's not by default on for me. So the whole entire beginning just isn't done. So I just screen recorded like most of the coloring process. And this is very, very tedious because you have to go frame by frame and use the fill bucket. And also, if you don't use the fill bucket, just use a pen tool. And I did all of the lighter color in the eye done by hand, but you know. It's like really tedious for absolutely no reason. And yeah, it took a long, long time. And the way I did this was I basically had all of the color palette and the sketch on the background layer. I set the background to that image, and then I just colored it all in and like drew it all on top of that, which actually made everything easier for me. And that's what I usually do. And then getting into the eyebrows, which is pretty speedy, I guess. I don't know. It wasn't too bad. And I just realized I could use the selection tool, but the selection tool didn't work all the time, so I just had to move it around until I realized that was way slower. So then I went right back to using the fill bucket, like, after this. Yeah, that's when I went back to the fill bucket. Anyways, I found this recording that I did when I was making this, so, you know, enjoy, bro.
Alright, it's supposed to be 1 a.m. as I record this. So anyways, we're gonna do the eyes. I don't know how I'm gonna approach this. Cause basically, the way Helios's eyes work, they go like... So I'm gonna do only one of them. It goes like this, and then it's kinda like darker on the top. And then you have the color, lighter color, and then the lighter color. So I plan to do something like this. But the thing is, I have to do that this many times. So either I need to find a way to shortcut this, or I'm gonna be in pain for the next 3.5 hours. I have to wake up at 8 in the morning. Oh shit, man.
Yeah, I don't know what that was either. As you can see, I can get my motivation bursts like in the middle of the night for no reason. So yeah. Anyways, so this eye coloring thing and the lip sync and stuff as before, I tracked, took exactly the same amount of time, and that kind of is weird to think about because the eyes were a lot simpler because basically most of it was just coloring. Like, I maybe had to color like 3 or 4 different things, but then I just had to duplicate it the whole way. Also, all this fiddling is me messing with my music because I was like hanging on by a thread because it was 1 a.m. So, ADHD. So this is what it's like. Yeah, a lot of this is just coloring and fixing coloring mistakes and then fiddling around and then fiddling around more and then fiddling around more. That's kind of coloring in general, but you know, I don't know why the hell I made Helios's eyes so complicated. They were way worse before. The only reason I put in their, like, on their toy house that you can make the eyes however you want is because they're way too complicated. Look, complicated is fun, but it's never easy. So, yeah. Yeah, this was kind of entertaining. And this is where I take my hand cramp poo break. I took a poo, I guess. TMI, thank you, form previous me. Anyways, so I was back, and back to thing. Yeah, I'm honestly surprised at 1 a.m. I didn't forget the colors that Helios's eyes, like, go on, like, which side they go on. Honestly, I forget that quite a lot. I'm surprised I didn't forget it at freaking 1 a.m, bro. Anyways, so I was done, and I did this. I don't know why. Anyways, okay, next step. Now this is the scary part. This is the part where I do the line art. And it's utterly terrifying the whole time. I also have to color it, and I don't shade it because I'm way too lazy. So yeah, it's gonna be a long one. All right, so now we're doing the line art. The line art actually for this was very, very quick. And you're noticing that I'm just, you know, doing it pretty quick, making sure to close all the lines that I can. For this. So this is basically just blocking in the colors, and getting everything ready. Now, some of these little, like, line art pieces aren't all the way connected. So right now, I'm just filling in all the connected ones and then hiding them. So the ones that are disconnected, I'm duplicating that layer, connecting it, and then I'm filling in that space and then deleting the duplicated layer, if that makes any sense. And that just gives me a layer that I can color on top of later, but I'm just getting that layer that I can color on ahead of time. So, you know, it's pretty simple. Pretty simple. All right, so at this point, I think I can just show you how I do it rather than explaining it to you. So we're gonna use this paw right here. We're gonna hide all the layers that are touching it just so we can make it easier to see. And we're gonna pretend that this layer wasn't here. So we have this layer and we need to connect it. So right now, we want to duplicate it. We want to, you know, get ready to color in. So we have duplicated it, and then we select our brush tool, and we have the color that we want to color block it in with. We fill in that edge, and this is on one of the duplicated layers. And then we go to the select thing at the top. We're gonna go to automatic, and then we're gonna select it. So we're scrolling left and right will adjust how intense the selection is. So we're just gonna do it just before it fills in all the way. And then we're gonna click this button at the bottom that says invert, and that just makes it so all that's inside is selected. And then we are going to go back to the layers. We're going to make a new layer. We are going to click that layer and fill layer. And then we are going to delete the duplicated layer. And this makes a color block thing. And at some point, you'll get used to it. You'll get muscle memory to it, and you can just do that super duper fast. That wasn't super fast, but you know, that's because I explained it. Now that I've explained it, coloring is like way easier. So you're gonna like have your mind blown. All right, now watch this. Click on the color block layer, alpha lock, select the color you wanna fill it with. And I'm just gonna get a brush. I'm just gonna get it off my master list. And then we're gonna, and as you can see, we don't color out the lines because it's alpha locked. You have no idea. I sped this part of the video up so much, bro. Anyways, so yeah, fun fact, I actually do Helios's pattern all by hand. Yeah, muscle memory's got it down for me now, so I don't even have to do stock images or whatever. Yeah. So yeah, this part took me about 20 minutes. It's like the third longest part in comparison to the lip syncing and the longest part, which is obviously video editing. So yeah, it didn't take me super duper long, but you know, could have been shorter. It's mostly because of the pattern. Also, the hair that Helios is rocking right now is my real-life hair. I just took a picture of the hairstyle and referenced it onto this, like, little makeshift ref sheet you can see on the top left corner every once in a while. So, yeah. Yeah, very fun. Coloring. Alright. And finally, the last step before video editing is this. So, okay. So, now we have all the parts, and now you're probably wondering, how do I export them? So, yeah, there's a lot of layers. So assuming your layers are all grouped, which they should be, they should be grouped. If they're not grouped, I'm coming to your house as we speak. So they should be grouped, and all of the layers that you do not want to be exported should be hidden. And we can go to settings and animation assist. And this puts every single one of our layers into what would hypothetically be a frame in an animation. Except we are not animating. So, you know, it's all right. It's all right. But, you know, since we are not animating, obviously we're not going to use this feature as intended, but we're still going to use it. So the way we're going to use it is we're going to go back to settings, share, and then there's a share layers section under share image. There's one option that says PNG files, and that will share each individual layer as a different image, and we're going to use that. Except I've already done this in a previous take, which was a blooper, which I will not be using, but, you know, I'm not going to export that all again because I do not have enough storage for that. So, yeah. Anyways. And that gives us all this. The rest of this video is just going to be purely on video editing and different little tips and help things. So if you need any help on something specific, there are going to be chapters in this video if you want to skip to certain chapters, and there are going to be timestamps in the description. Enjoy the rest of the video, and I hope you liked it. Now at this point, we're in a light motion, so we're going to start it. So yeah. So we're going to push this plus button at the bottom, and we're going to start making our project. So we're going to name it, if you want. I usually don't name it, but I'm going to name it today. So I'm going to name it a very good name. And now we're going to do it. So we're going to do 16 by 9 because that's the standard YouTube resolution. And we're going to do 1080p because that's nice and crisp quality. Frame rate is going to be, let's say, 60 frames per second. Like, I'll just take 60, dude. Background light gray, sure. And now, here we are. Alright, so at this point in the screen recording, my mic was on, but I kind of started rambling and I forgot about the mic. So, you know, it just kind of got boring, so I'm just going to do voiceover. So at this point, I am adding bookmarks and then stretching the little rectangle at the beginning, which is going to be our title card, to the end of the bookmark. And so the font that I'm using here is my own handwriting, of course, because I made it into a font. And yeah, this is me playing around with it. Animation meme. It's the original meme. It's Lady Gaga, of course. So I did letter spacing with this, kind of funky. So yeah. The title card is usually what I start with, so then I actually have something. So, because I find when I don't do the title card first, I just go straight to the animation, and then I get lazy and I just slack off on the title card later. So why would I do that when I could just put in actual effort now and then, you know. Anyways, so he's me messing around with the new effect that just came out, echo keyframes. It's cool, but only if you have the count thing set to 1 for whatever reason. So yeah. Yes, I have a light motion premium, by the way. So camera tool, which has been out for a little bit now and I love, and then adding the little 4-pointed star as usual. It is my favorite shape, so you know. Alright, so I think this is a good place to put in a walkthrough. So this is actually starting off the tweening part. Not really doing it, but starting it off. So I always start with the animation before the background. I used to do the background before the animation, but I don't know. Just works better with the animation before. So we're going to start with the layers behind. We're going to put those first, and then we're going to do the next layer. And I need to add the face, so let's do that now. Okay, now to get the face in, so we're gonna look at the colors first. So we're gonna green screen it in, but we're not gonna green screen it like normal people and use green. So as you'll notice, on the color wheel, yellow is pretty close to green. So if we do green screen, there's a pretty big chance that it might confuse the green with the yellow. So we're gonna look. So the colors that we're looking at are pink and yellow. And what is on the opposite side of pink and yellow? Cyan. So we're going to use cyan for the green screen. The only other colors are black, which doesn't really have a
color value. And like very, very dark browns, which are in the reds and oranges. So we're going to use a cyan for the background. Gotta use your green screen smart, children, please. Thank you. So here we go. So now we're gonna save that as a video. And now we're gonna go back to a light motion. We can add the green screen. And the audio starts at the beginning for the green screen too, so the face should get in right there. And we're going to go to effects. Add effect, chroma key, and we have to tell it that instead of using green, we're actually going to use this. Uh-oh, so we got to size that properly. Hi, voiceover Greg back. Yeah. So what I'm doing right here is adding an inner glow, and this just kind of helps the little scraggliness of the outside of the lines from the green screen. Green screens are never perfect, like all the colors always are off or something like that. It's always something stupid. So yeah. Okay, mini lecture time. All right, we're gonna talk about layer parenting. This is one of the most important things nowadays. Very important. So first of all, name your layers. Name them. I'll name them in a minute. Second, we get back to the time lapse. But very quickly, I want to show you layer parenting. So layer parenting is basically this: the face is on a different layer from the head. So I parented the face to the head, which means the head is the parent of the face. That doesn't sound correct, but you'll understand in a minute. Which means the face moves exactly with the head. When the head moves, the face moves. When the face moves, the head doesn't move because it's the child. But when the head moves, the face moves. If that makes any sense. The parent controls the child does not control the parent. So, yeah, and you can parent parents to parents. So if I wanted to, so I'm gonna parent the head. I want its parent to be the body. So when I move the body is the parent of the face, and the face is the parent, or the body is the parent of the head, and the head is the parent of the face. So all of them move together. But when I move the face, it moves independently from the body. Sounds really complicated, but I think you get it by now. And yeah, basically, we'll just create a whole entire web of all these parented layers. So parents can have multiple children layers. So I'm going to connect these two cheek furs to the parent. So now all of this moves together. They all can move independently, but they all move together. And now we're gonna discuss anchor points, because they're really painful. Okay, anchor points are kind of exactly what they sound. So they're just kind of pinpoints. So I'm gonna attach an anchor point to the head. So as you can see, there's like a gray dot in the middle of the screen. That's the anchor point. So to access the anchor point, so in a light motion, on the move and transform menu, there's like a bunch of all these little things. We're gonna go to the move one, and we're just gonna click it again. And this moves the anchor. So the head is attached to the neck, so we're just gonna add it to the neck. So now, if we go to like any other thing, let's go to rotate. Head rotates around the neck, as you can see. And then it will enlarge from the neck. It will do everything. Now it will do everything from the neck. Now if I move the anchor point, for example, let's have it move to the paw. The head will now orbit around the paw. So basically we just kind of want it to anchor to where, like, what, just kind of think on your character where a joint would be. So I, you know, if we go behind the head, there's like the neck. I'm just gonna attach it to there, and that's how the anchor point works. And we would just go through all of the things and establish where we want their anchor points to be. All right, here's where the actual tweening starts. I know there's like at least 10 of you watching right now who just skipped to this part, and didn't watch any of the important stuff. I'm gonna tell you this, the setup is a lot more important than you think. So, I don't know, man. Rewind before it's too late. Anyways, so we're gonna start tweening. Okay, the audio's kind of loud, so I'm gonna go over the tweening kind of on myself. So what we're looking at right here is called a waveform, and it is kind of the audio, so we can see where the beat hits. So every time we have a beat hit, we're gonna add a bookmark. All right, and now. Right here, we can kind of see where the beat starts to do the thing. See a little hump in there? I'm just gonna add a thing to the little hump too. And now let's play it and look at how the hump goes. Okay, so now we're gonna use that as kind of our basis for this. So I always like to start tweening with the head. It's not a must, but it's a like. So we're gonna have it reach its climax, which is just like the furthest position down it'll go. So we're gonna have it go like this and go back up. And you know what? I'm gonna move the anchor point a little bit so then it's kind of less rigid. There we go. It's a little laggy because of the screen recording, but it's okay. So we want it to go ease in, and then we're gonna have it ease out here. Now it's just kind of laggy because of the screen recording and everything, but as you can see, we just added that to here, and then we just added the motion graphs, and these we're gonna ease them out. We're gonna make them a little bit less intense, and we're just gonna repeat that process. So every time we hit a bookmark, we are going to do this, and then we're gonna have it go down. And what degree did that go down? Okay, that went down negative 11, so we're gonna have this also go down negative 11. Alright, so what I did here is I added an extra little camera element, and I did the tweening for the face, and basically we would rinse and repeat for every single body part. Voiceover Greg back again, wow. Okay, so at this point I just started tweening the hair, and it went pretty well until I got really, really, really tired of all of the lag. So at this point, I was like, no more screen recording. So after I do the hair, I just stopped doing the screen recording, finished the rest on my own, and I'll show you the render, and I'll show you the project. All right, here is, you know, this. This probably took me, I don't know, jeez, I have like almost an hour on this project. Still a little bit laggy, but honestly it could be worse, and I think it looks pretty good so far.
Alright, so I added some extra effects, which made it, yes, more laggy. So what I added is this like painting little cloud thing, which is made by doing three layers, or four layers. The back, which is this little canvas, the back cloud, the middle cloud, the front cloud, then I'm shoving Helios in between it, and then Helios has motion blur and smooth bevel on all of the layers, which just makes them look really shiny and kind of fancy, and I kind of love it. It's kind of weird. So yeah, I think that's the final update. Yeah, and I'm gonna funk up this stuff more a little bit. But, you know, I think that's good.
All right, so time to show the final render. So, yeah. If you want to see more videos like this and you really like this video, let me know. And I might do a background video because I kind of skimmed that over in this video. Yeah. Cool. Goodbye.